And to know more about tuberculosis or TB, we are now connected with pulmonologist Dr. Diah Handayani. Hello, doctor.
Hello.
Yes, thank you for your time. And let's go straight to our first question. What are the early symptoms of TB that we need to be aware of?
Okay, the first symptom that well known, I think, is coughing. And then beside coughing, some patient also bloody coughing, and also night sweat, low sweat, and in the severe condition, some of them also breathlessness. That's the symptom of TB, and also loss of appetite.
In addition to the lungs, will the disease have any effect or in other parts of the body?
Yeah, actually TB come to the lung as an enter point of the mycobacterium. But after that, not everybody become sick directly after the infection. So at that time, TB will be covered by our immune system, but while it happen, it also can be separate to other organ from brain, eye, uveitis TB, conjunctivitis TB, and also ear, and also a lymph node in the whole body. We have lymph node, but mostly in the neck, and also liver, kidney, ovarium, uterus, scrotum, even bone, and also other organ, and also skin. In the whole body, we can get infected with TB.
So there is a possibility that this can go as this can have a systemic reaction. And just to know, could you please explain how tuberculosis can be transmitted?
Okay, actually, it mostly patient get infected in the lung, and the source of mycobacterium not only to the body of the patient who was sick, but also for others, because TB can be transmitted through sputum that exhaled by a patient with TB. And then when we inhale the sputum with mycobacterium TB, in the condition where there's a lot of the mycobacterium, so the mycobacterium or the bug will enter our lung. And after that, they will live there and will be covered by our immune system. But for the patient who have a weakening in the immune system, especially in the lung immune system, so it can be directly become sick, especially for a patient with smoking very much, and also patient with very weak condition in the immune system, such as HIV, and also diabetes mellitus, and also malnutrition. That's how it transmits. But if the patient already being infected, but with a good immune system, sometimes the body or the immune system can take over the mycobacterium, so it become an inactive TB. We call it latent TB infection. For the patient like that, it is we have a chance to prevent the body become sick even we already get infected.
All right, so the next question is really important, particularly for me and Yasha. Pay attention for this, Yasha, because is it true, doctor, that men are more prone to TB development, and how is it possible?
Actually, men or women at the same position for the susceptibility to become TB, but there's some condition that make men prone to get TB rather than women, such as smoker is make the TB develop more to men or depend on woman. And also we can see that men more mobile and more have a social rather than women. That's why men become prone to TB rather than women. But actually in the genetic susceptibility, there's no difference between men and women to become TB.
All right, doctor, let's talk about smoking. As Indonesia is approximately, there's 50 7 million smokers in Indonesia. So is it true that smoking is a factor in the development of tuberculosis?
Yes, it's really true. Because smoking directly can make our immune system, especially in the lung, become very weak. That's why when we get infected with TB, so it's directly will be become our body, our lung becomes sick because there's no barrier or there's no immune system can protect us from TB. It could be 7 times rather than non-smoker to become TB rather than non-smoker for to get sick, not only to get infected.
So I actually have an aunt who recovered, thankfully, from TB, but it was a very rigorous process. Just out of curiosity, to clarify from you as the expert, do patients with tuberculosis have a good chance of full recovery? And I understand because from my experience, seeing my aunt, it was a very rigorous process. And even after she was, you know, she was declared healed, there are still after effects of TB. It's like long COVID with COVID-19. Is that true?
Yes, actually, as an infection disease, actually TB is curable. For the patient who get TB but still susceptible with the drug, we call it susceptible TB because there's a drug-resistant TB. For the susceptible TB, actually the cure rate more than 90%. So almost 90 to 95% who get TB but still susceptible to the drug, not resistant to the drug, it can be cured well. But some people can get after or post-TB syndrome, like post-COVID syndrome, because TB can also make a destruction in the lung. Sometimes it make the lung become shrinkage and fibrosis. That's why the patient still coughing or breathlessness because it can be clear in the lung. It also depend on our immune system and also our nutrition condition. That's why it is very important for a patient with TB not only taking the drug but also eat well with a good nutrition and also have a good health life such as exercise and also sleep in enough time. It's very important to be cured in the TB treatment program. And also quit the smoking, because if we take the drug but we don't quit the smoke, we still smoking, so the drug can cure the TB, but the smoking effect will also destroy, so the lesion or the nodule in our lung not really clear. That's why it's very important not only taking the drug but also have a good health life and a lifestyle and also enough food and good nutrition. It's very important to in TB treatment. But for TB who already become resistant with the drug, there's many right now we have also a lot of people with resistant to the TB drug. We call it drug resistant tuberculosis, which they already become resistant with the backbone of TB drug like rifampicin and isoniazid. And for that kind of TB, it's very difficult to be cured, because we need a lot of drug, more than we usually give, and also it takes longer time. But actually, the problem of TB treatment is not only because of the drug not effective, but the most important thing is the adherence of the patient to take the drug regularly. Because it needs unless 6 months to 20 months to cure the TB in our body. That's the really a big problem.
All right, so doctor, our next question is, in order to achieve or reach to the status of full recovery. So actually, how many treatments and therapies are needed? And is it true that TB is a hereditary disease?
Okay. For the treatment, as I said, there's two kind of treatment. For the susceptible, we give 4 drugs minimum for 6 months. Right now, we give 4 drugs for 6 months. But in the future, there's another drug, but not, but still in a study, that we can cure TB only 2 months, but it's not still in the study. But for the drug resistant TB, we need more than 5 drugs to cure the TB, and it takes longer. It's more than 9 to 20 months. It depends how we can give many kind of drug. If we can, if the patient can, we think is not very severe, we can give only 9 months treatment. But for patient with very severe condition, we have to give the patient more than 20 months or at least 20 months for the treatment. That's why it become difficult, not only because of the drug not effective, as I say, but also the adherence. That's why in TB treatment, the patient really need support from the family, especially from everybody in the environment, in the community. That's why in TB treatment, we don't only give the treatment, we don't only give the drug, but we ask the family to support the patient. That's very important too. So is TB hereditary in the in our family? Actually, TB not a hereditary disease, but sometimes we will give TB in our families, since if we only give the treatment to the patient who sick. I mean, if somebody in the house have TB, such as a children has TB, actually we have to look for everybody in who live in the same house. And after that, we look for whether the fathers or the mother also get TB. We have to to also care the family. But if the family not already become sick with TB, we have to explore whether the family also has already become infected with TB. That's what I call latent TB. And we have to stop that, and we can give the preventive treatment. That's the new strategy in our Ministry of Health program, that right now being very important thing to stop TB, not only treat the patient who already getting sick, but we also treat to prevent the patient who already become infected, but not already become sick. That what we call latent TB. Especially for the one who, for the children less than 5 years old, and also for the patient with HIV or patient who very weak condition in immune system, such as a patient who or must take some drug that can weakening the immune system. That's very important. But right now in Indonesia, not only for the children or very very bad immune system persons, but right now we try to look for all the family member to protect them become TB. So if somebody get TB, please come with the whole family to be checked, to be evaluated whether they already get sick or already get infected, such as COVID. Actually, TB and COVID really the same in the process of transmission.
Yeah, we were gonna say that, Doc, because you know, ever since we are in the pandemic, people are more aware of respiratory diseases and how to prevent it, right?
But it's like tracing.
Right. It's like tracing. So we have to protect our family. And again, I'm sure this makes your job easier in when you're consulting with your patients. Thank you very much for your time, and I think we'll speak again soon. I guess we are, speaking of COVID, we're still in the pandemic. Hopefully we're going to get into endemic state.
Yes.
So thank you so much. We'll be speaking with you again, Doc. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Yeah.